Hello friends, welcome to my channel, and in this video I'm going to teach you that how to convert some image into some other format by using convert tool, which is a part of Imagemagick. And you might don't know what I'm talking about, so let's just start from the beginning. So the thing is, there is a I once asked my friend that can you convert a image, colored image, into a black and white image. So what he did is he goes like online image editor on Google, and this is so bad. I mean, he opened some online random editor, and there are ads, but I'm using ad blocker, and he uploaded his personal image on a cloud server, which is just random cloud server. And after doing the editing, he downloaded the image, and every time when he do it, he used some weird editors, and he don't know how to use these editors. So this is so bad. I mean, he got his own computer, but he's not using his own computer, he's using some cloud shit. So that's it. Today I'm going to teach you how to use Imagemagick too, so you can do some basic things properly. You can also use GIMP, but it's always good to know how to do some basic stuff by just using Imagemagick, because it's a CLI tool which allow you to script things. Like for example, if you got 100 of images, you just want to resize it for for your website, you can just do it by using Imagemagick, which is way more convenient to use. And I believe that it's a really good tool for web developers and some other people who work with photos a lot. So let's just get started. I just installed it. It's in mean arch package repo. And after doing this, there are a bunch of tools which you get. So let me go into this YT folder, and I have this sample.jpg. So I can use this display tools which come with Imagemagick to just see this image. So as you can see, this is the image I got, and let's just close it and clear the screen. So again, ls. So this is my image, and let's just use one more tool, convert tool. So this is a tool which comes with Imagemagick. It's a very powerful tool, and you can do a lot of things like blur, crop, and a lot of stuff. Now I'm not going to teach you how to crop or resize, which is very important. This is the part of some other video, but in this video, just the effects, because there are a lot of effects you can do, and let's just do it. Alright, so for example, if you just want to solarize the image, so what you can do is you can type convert and then solarize and then 40%. So here you have to type percentage, but there are some other things which I will discuss later. Most of the time you end up writing the value here, and here the filter flag. Alright, so here the filter flag is solarize. So let's just press enter, and now if I do ls, you can see there is the output .jpg, and this time I'm going to use SXIV, my default image peer, because I don't like display. I mean, it's fine, it's for Imagemagick, it's not a image peer. So you can see this is like solarize effect. Now you might don't know a lot about effects, but let me just try to give you a little bit hint or something. So what are some basic effects which I can apply? You can add some modulate effect, so modulate and then 50 sample.jpg output jpeg. All right so let's press enter, and again SXIV output.jpeg. So you can see the brightness is low this time, and if you change this number from higher than 100, all right so this time like 150, and press enter and open the image. So this time you can see it's more bright, so cool. So yeah, changing brightness is cool, but I want to do more. For example, I want to add blur. So how to add blur? This is another very important thing. So you have to type something like this. So first we wrote some percentage value, then some number, and this time what is this? Even I don't know what is this. It's just some hexadecimal number, and let's just run this, and you can see. So as you can see, I'm not very good, but I know how to do things. So this is how you blur. The more this number is, so instead of 3, if I do this 10, you can see the more blur is. Alright, so how cool is that? Most people do these kind of stuff, like if they are web developer, they might want some background which is blurred, so they can just use this simple tool instead of opening GIMP for some photo editor. So let's just do quickly one more thing. For example, negate. So negate is one more thing which happened on photos. So it's just a effect, I don't know how to explain it. Here if you notice, there is no number, because all you have to do is just negate. So negate is like invert. Why I am typing output here, SXIV. So you can see this is like invert image, I guess. I don't know what this is, but yeah, this is how things work. So let's do some charcoal. Charcoal is also effect. So charcoal. So here if I pass value 1 and then give our input, which is sample.jpg and then output.jpg. So you can see this time it's, you know, whitish, I guess. So it's really hard for me to explain you the effects. All I can tell you is that if you increase the value, it's going to take a little bit of time. So keep this in mind, and you can see the power of Imagemagick right now. It can do almost everything, every basic effect. You can just apply it by using, you know, just Imagemagick. So now let's just quickly change a colored image into a grayscale image. So what you have to do is color space gray. So just type gray here and then sample JPEG output JPEG and open it with SXIV. You can see this is a grayscale image, and let's just clear the screen again. You can also apply border if you want, which is so cool. I mean, a lot of time you need border on an image in case if you are writing an article or something. So all you have to pass is first border color. So let's do red here. You can also pass RGB value if you want. So you have to type RGB and then some value like 200, 0, 0. So this is how you pass RGB value. I'm just going to type right here and then some border value, so the thickness basically. So the thickness is 10 and sample jpg output.jpg and just open it. So you can see the red border I got. How cool is that? Now let's just quickly change the saturation of an image. So what you have to type again, convert, modulate, and then there are two values. So we use modulate before for, you know, brightness stuff, but you can also, you know, add here another value which is for saturation. So we are just increasing the saturation. I'm just trying to show you the kind of things you can do with Imagemagick, and this is just filter. So you can also do resizing image and a lot more. One of my favorite is vignette. So if you want some nostalgic effect, you can just put a convert and then background is equal to like black. So it's not is equal to, it's just, you know, argument and then the parameter. And this is vignette. So this is very important to understand. So these value, I will tell you what these value do. I think you can understand by your own. The higher the number is, the more the smoothness is. I think when you see it, you will understand it better. So it took a little bit amount of time, but you can see it's providing all this, you know, black circle type of thing. So let me just quickly increase the number so you can see better. Let me just quickly decrease the number so you can understand better. The lesser the number is, more stronger the effect is. So you can see this is very strong right now. And one last thing I just want to show you is paint effect. So you can also, you know, change image into, you know, some kind of paint, oil painting kind of thing. So you can see it. So it's so cool, and I think it's very useful to, you know the basic of Imagemagick. I'm going to make one more video for resizing, cropping, and some, you know, more advanced thing in Imagemagick. But that's it for this video, and please learn this. If you should not always Google these kind of stuff, you should know at least the basics. So if you want to do, you know, some stuff quickly on some image, you can just do it instantly. Thanks for watching.